Well, welcome everyone to this Hastings Parking Precinct Plan information session. I'd like to thank you all for coming and welcome to everyone who's watching us at home. Before we start, I'd like to do an acknowledgement of country. Mornington Peninsula Shire acknowledges and pays respect to the Boonwurrung Boonwurrung people, the traditional custodians of these lands and waters. Now I'll hand over to Theo to start the presentation.
Yeah, thanks so much, Katanya. So my name's Theo. I work for IE Community, and we've been engaged by the Shire to work on this parking project for almost a year now. So we've been talking to stakeholders in the community about parking since December 2019. We've set up a stakeholder reference group in Hastings to work through some of the issues about parking in a lot more detail, and we'll talk about that in a second. And look, our role tonight is really to answer some of the questions that we've been hearing from the community, so that you're all set up and have the knowledge you need to understand the project, and also to provide feedback on the recommendations up on the website. So like I've just said, tonight we're going to give you an understanding of the project, give you the information you need to provide feedback, and also to ask some questions of the project team. And up on the screen here are the questions that we're going to work through tonight. I won't read them out because you'll read them off. But I might hand back to Katanya to give a bit of an overview of why Hastings needs this project.
Yeah, so why does Hastings need this project? Thanks, Theo. So basically, Hastings is growing. It's identified as a major activity centre in planning terms, which means that it's a location for increased population, housing, retail, commercial growth into the future. Parking can already be a challenge. It's not critical at this point, but we want to make sure that it's considered and we do something about it before it gets critical. And parking is linked to the economic activity of Hastings. So the easier it is for people to find a park, the more likely it is that they'll spend money in Hastings. So it's really about setting the long-term vision for how we plan for parking and how we'll manage it into the future. So looking at where are we now and where do we want to be in the future. It's not about outdoor dining and street closures, and it's not about paid parking. It's really about the long-term parking future. So what is a parking precinct plan? As I said, it's a long-term plan to set out how parking should be provided and managed. So it's basically a background review of how parking is working. It looks at the data, and it also talks to community members, and we want to know from the community what's working from your point of view. There's 14 recommendations, which are around managing current parking and also planning for future parking supply. And it's trying to answer some key questions. So can we manage our existing parking supplies better, or do we need more? And looking into the future, how does new development need to provide parking? So in terms of where this parking precinct plan applies, it's this blue area here. So it's basically the major activity centre of Hastings. I might hand over here, Theo, to you.
Yeah, thanks so much. So as I mentioned before, this project kicked off late 2019. So it's been running all of 2020 through COVID. But before COVID, you know, hit, there were these two processes going on at the same time. So some parking surveys that were done by traffic engineers and this community consultation process, the stakeholder reference group. Both of those things were really looking at how parking's working at the moment and looking at how we can provide better for the future. And the Shire used them to develop this draft plan. So at the moment, we're in public exhibition, which closes on the 20th of December. And that's basically an opportunity for everyone in Hastings, so the local residents, traders, people who come through to provide feedback on all the proposed changes and really just make sure that it works for them, that the Shire isn't putting anything forward that they think is going to have negative outcomes for Hastings. So once public exhibition wraps up on the 20th of December, the Shire will then go through some approvals to finalise the plan and look at getting it adopted in April of 2021. So I've just mentioned that there were some traffic engineers involved doing some parking surveys. Now, these weren't the engineers standing out on the street and asking people about parking. It wasn't that kind of survey. It was actually a car with a camera on top of it, driving around and automatically counting the car spaces in Hastings and how many of them were full. So those were undertaken. There were a couple of dates in January and a date in March just before COVID restrictions came into place. And that those surveys were intended to answer three questions. So the first one here is, how much parking is there? How much of that parking is actually being used? And how long do people park? And in terms of what they found, there are almost 4,000 parking spaces in Hastings. And again, about a pretty even number of those are on street and off street. So about 2,000 on street and about 2,000 off street as well. And look, the really key finding that came out through all of this is that on average across the major activity center, parking is about 34% full. So that means that at any one time, on average, all across the center of Hastings there, about 35% of car parks are being used. Now that's interesting because the accepted wisdom for managing parking is that parking should actually be about 85% full on average. So that 85% figure is actually the best balance between, you know, supporting economic activity, but still making it easy enough for people to be able to find a park. And I should also mention that 85% figure, it's not about trying to provide parking during, you know, the busiest peak periods of the year, you know, over Christmas or Easter when everyone flocks down to go on holidays. It's about managing the busy periods throughout the year. So, you know, what's it like living in Hastings day to day? Gets busy on the weekend, and there are a few periods in the week when it gets busy. So look, this 34% figure, so 34% of parking is being used, it is much lower than that 85% target that I've just mentioned. But look, I think the major caveat there is that some areas were much, much busier than others. So there were areas in Hastings that saw, you know, pretty much no parking, where all parking was open, was not being used. But there were also locations, you know, along High Street, for example, that were really quite busy. So we'll look at a map that explains that a little bit better in just a moment. And this third thing, you know, the third result here is that a lot of drivers are actually parking for longer than they should. So about a quarter of all drivers are overstaying the restrictions. So like I've mentioned, the really key thing that came out of this process is that parking isn't really a huge problem across the center of town as a whole, but there are some hotspots that need to be addressed. And I mentioned this map just a second ago as well. It might be a little bit difficult to see on the screen, but you can see that, for example, the red line in the middle of the maps here, that's High Street. And that basically says that more than 85% of the parking was full at any one time. So like I mentioned, you can see that right in the center, it gets very full, you know, over 85%, but the majority of Hastings, you know, in the green streets is actually under 60%. And a lot of it's much lower than that. So that's where that discrepancy comes from. So that's the parking surveys. It's basically found that overall, it's not a massive problem across the center of town, but there are some hotspots. And look, that was broadly reflected in what the community has said so far as well. So I mentioned a couple of minutes ago that we set up a stakeholder reference group as part of this process. And their role was really to identify the key issues around parking, workshop some ideas, and review the draft plan as well. And that group included representatives from, you know, the Chambers of Commerce, the traders, local tourism reps, residents, the school, aged care facility, some community groups, and also, you know, council's advisory groups for youth, for elderly folks, and for disabled people as well. So over three workshops, the key things that they kind of pulled out were that accessible parking is really, really important. And actually, there's a lack of disabled parking along High Street, and also that compliance with the current kind of design guidelines isn't really there. They also mentioned that it can be difficult to actually find available parking, particularly along High Street in the Kmart car park, and in the Kmart car park. Again, with these parking restrictions, people think that long-term parking is still really important, but there was some support for providing more short-term parking for people who, you know, needed to kind of come in and make a quick stop and head out, you know, for example, picking up takeaway. And there was obviously limited support for paid parking. Paid parking wasn't considered as part of this process at all. But there were a couple of, you know, more cheeky mentions in the group that maybe we could make the tourists pay for parking. But look, paid parking wasn't at all considered any further than that as part of this process. And the last thing that the community mentioned that I'll talk about is some overspill from new developments. So the new developments near High Street that are creating some more parking challenges nearby. And look, we obviously heard much, much more than that from the group. And you can read through everything that they said in the plan itself. So the full report from those sessions is included in the plan. And you're welcome to have a flick through yourself, because it is really some interesting and really valuable information that went into the development of the plan.
So yeah, just while you're having a quick drink of water, Councillor Dixon, there's this new device that you've been given is the same as mine, and there's a little slide thing above the camera. So you can see, even though my camera is technically on in the Zoom, if you slide that open, it will come open. So it's a manual thing. It's some IT thing. I hope that fixes your camera. Thanks, Theo. Sorry to interrupt.
No worries. So we'll talk now about what the main changes being proposed are. So there are 14 recommendations in the plan. And look, a recommendation is basically something that's being proposed will change in the future. So 10 of those are about changing the current situation to improve the current situation. So that's stuff like parking restrictions, improving signage, pedestrian access, enforcement and events. And there are also 4 in there to help manage future parking. So more around planning and regulations and that sort of thing. So like I said, we'll go through 6 of these now just to give you a bit of background, but the rest of them are in the plan and you should have a look in more detail either in the plan or in the survey as well. So recommendation 1 is to change parking restrictions on High Street to 1 hour. And look, spaces that currently have restrictions that are shorter than 1 hour won't be changed at all. So look, why is this being proposed? What's the kind of value of this? It's about helping increase the turnover of car parks so that more people can access them. So basically we're getting more people, you know, kind of pulling out and pulling in of car parks at any one time, so that overall there are more spaces available for people who need them. It also gives priority in the busiest areas to people who are only making a quick stop. Now, I mentioned before, people are making a quick stop out the front of, you know, the takeaway joint, grabbing a kebab and wanting to run home. It also reduces the number of cars circulating on High Street while they try and find a park. And the last thing that I'll mention on this one is that it does make parking restrictions a bit more consistent on High Street. So it makes it sort of easier for people to choose where to park, and also makes it easier for signage about the restrictions to be clearer and more consistent. Recommendation 2 is about introducing 2-hour parking restrictions on all of the north-south roads that connect to High Street, excuse me. And we have a map on the next slide to just sort of explain where they are. But, you know, I think King Street, Victoria Street, Queen Street and Salmon Street. So 2 hour restrictions on all of those. And similarly with the recommendation 1 that we've just talked about, the idea here is to help increase the turnover of parking spaces. So allowing more people to actually park there, and also to provide spaces for people who usually park longer than 1 hour on High Street. So the idea is that if you do go to High Street and you park for 2 hours, if recommendation 1 was to be approved, then you would have to park in one of these north-south roads instead. And you can see up on the screen now which roads that's really talking about. So recommendation 3, and look, by the way, these are, I should have mentioned before, these are all up in the plan online and in the website, in the survey as well. And we'll talk at the end about how to access the website and other ways for how you can provide feedback on all of this as well. So recommendation 3 is about improving the enforcement of parking restrictions, and that will help improve access and improve movement as well. So why are we doing that? Basically to support recommendations 1 and recommendation 2. There's not much point changing restrictions if you're not going to enforce them. And it's really about encouraging people to comply with those new restrictions in order to support those two recommendations. So increase the turnover of parking and availability for all users. Recommendation 5 here is about diverting larger vehicles away from High Street. So using signage to actually direct caravans and trailers along Elizabeth Street rather than High Street to get around the town centre. And the idea is that, you know, why are we doing this? The idea is that directing drivers, you know, who are towing or have larger vehicles to available on-street parking on Elizabeth Street is probably more suitable for their needs in terms of their vehicle size than parking on High Street. Recommendation 10 is about, and Matt, you're welcome to jump in here if you would like to, is about considering using additional parking management techniques like smart parking technology. So if you've been to Rye recently, you'll probably have bumped into the smart parking technology, and that's to help us manage parking. So the idea is to use data from that smart parking technology to make better future decisions about restrictions and enforcement and that kind of thing. So improve how efficiently people use parking, reduce traffic congestion and vehicle emissions, generate new parking data to inform decision making, and also make use of existing parking capacity. Look, we'll turn now to managing parking in the future. So all those 5 recommendations that we've just run through are about managing kind of existing parking conditions. And this recommendation is about looking forward, how can we sort of best set ourselves up for the future? So one of the really important decisions to make when it comes to managing future parking is about what parking rates should be used. So parking rates actually refer to how many parking spaces the Shire requires developers to provide. So when developers provide either build new buildings or they change use, so they change from, for example, a shop over to a restaurant, how many parking spaces are they required to provide? So at the moment, the Shire is using the parking rates in column A. So that's the column on the left-hand side of this table here. So that basically means that the Shire requires developers to provide this much parking. So for example, if a new office is built, the Shire requires developers to provide 3.5 spaces per 100 square meters of floor space in that office. So that's what's happening at the moment. But the parking surveys that I mentioned before have actually found that, you know, while there are some challenges, the Hastings Town Centre doesn't have a massive parking problem in terms of numbers overall, in terms of the total number of cars trying to find a car park. So the column A rates that are being used at the moment aren't actually perfectly suited to the Hastings Major Activity Centre. And what this means is that more space than necessary is being taken up by car parking, which is actually stopping that space being used for other things like parks or shops or pedestrian walkways. And the surveys have found that the current demand for parking, you know, how much is actually being used, is actually more in line with column B, so the column on the right-hand side of the table here. So that is the recommendation, is to change from column A to column B. So for example, this would reduce the requirement for a new shop from having to provide 4 spaces per 100 square meters to 3.5 spaces per 100 square meters. So look, it's not a massive shift. It's not going to be kind of immediate overnight, but it is over time going to provide a kind of a better use for Hastings. So what's the value of that? Basically, it's about avoiding an oversupply of parking in the future. It's also a way of simplifying the planning system for change of use applications. So I mentioned when developers, you know, they want to change use from, for example, a restaurant and they want to turn into a retail shop. It makes that system a lot more efficient and easier for everyone. It provides a greater level of consistency in how the Shire assesses and considers parking reductions for developers. And it also potentially reduces VCAT costs. So we've just worked through six of the real key recommendations that we've had a lot of questions about so far. Now it's about everyone in Hastings getting online and providing feedback on these six, but also making sure to look at all 14 of the recommendations as well. So public exhibition is open until the 20th of December. You can head online on this link here, and you can complete a survey, you can provide a submission, and you're also welcome to call up and have a chat as well. You know, a lot of people don't want to use a website to provide feedback, so you can call up and have a chat to someone in the Shire team as well. I guess the last thing I'll note is that all the plans and the survey are also available in hard copy at the libraries. So if you would like a hard copy version of the survey, head down to the library and you can fill one out that way. So look, the Shire is really looking for as much feedback on these recommendations as possible. They're really interested in making sure that the plans actually reflect what people in Hastings who, you know, live there and work there need and want day to day. So it'd be fantastic if you could, you know, share this website and share this plan with as many people as you can, you know, your friends and your family and your colleagues, to make sure that we actually get this parking planning right for the future. So look, thanks so much for tuning in. Katanya, was there anything else that you would like to add?
No, that's great. Thanks, Leo.
Great, thanks so much. I think we'll stop the recording there before we head into questions.